Morning. It is Monday, October 3rd. It's a beautiful fall day, and I am officially unemployed. It is currently 53 degrees, but it's warming up fast. We do have some fall colors coming through. I am back at the Bear Creek Overlook for the last time. As you know, we're moving to Arkansas soon, so I want to hike some of my favorite hikes before we leave. So being unemployed feels extremely strange for me. It's rare that I get this much time off between jobs, but I've got at least 3 weeks before I go back to work. And in case you're wondering, no, I don't have anything lined up yet. This is kind of a, as I said before, reckless abandon venture here. While it does make me slightly nervous, I find the uncertainty both thrilling and exciting. Put 10 years into my career here in Montana, and while it has been frustrating and challenging, it's been a great learning opportunity for me. It's extremely easy to get into the mindset that challenges and adversity only result in a negative outcome. However, that couldn't be further from the truth. Every challenge provides us with a teachable moment. I interpret a lot of these teachable lessons as suffering, when in fact, it was preparing me for my future. With the obligation behind me and some time for self-reflection, the frustration and anger and resentment I felt towards my career are replaced with gratitude. I'm very thankful for the opportunity I had. This experience forced me out of my comfort zone and allowed me to connect with some really amazing people. People who have taught me a lesson in humility with their encouragement, support, and kind words. If I'm being honest, it's an honor I don't feel worthy of. As an introvert, it typically shies away from human connection. It's extremely hard for me to accept such high praise. That being said, I'm extremely grateful for those people. They made Montana feel like home. So what now? What's next? Well, we're in the middle of doing a lot of packing and trying to enjoy as much of Montana as we can before we leave. These trails are my sanctuary, my comfort, my place of self-reflection. And I'd be lying if I said I weren't sad that I'd be leaving them behind. But the focus now isn't what I stand to lose, it's what I stand to gain. There are new adventures to be had and new opportunities to pursue. Getting back to gratitude, I also want to mention how blessed we are to have this opportunity and to be able to do this. We all must be careful and mindful to not take our blessings for granted. We're almost there, but it has warmed up quite a bit, and I'm gonna ditch this sweater. All right, it's about another quarter mile until we get to the Overlook. I might do some additional exploring while I'm up there, seeing how this is the last time I'll be here. We are very close. Doesn't matter how many times I lay eye on this landscape, I'm still in awe every time. To be clear, I don't regret our decision. It is sad, especially sitting here, knowing we'll be leaving this behind. but there will be new discoveries, new adventures, and new opportunities to be had. I'm very grateful for the opportunity to spend 10 years here and venture to all these beautiful places. So as I said, I'm going to do some more exploring here, and I went up the ridge just a little bit and found this real cool area here. It's almost like natural stairs right there. So I think there's a way to get out up there, and I'm going to attempt it as long as it's not too sketchy. Don't try this at home, kids. Look at that view. For those of you that have followed me on this journey, thank you. This isn't the end of my story, just the beginning of a new chapter.